Running custom Stable Diffusion models can be excruciatingly slow if you don't have a dedicated graphics card. However, after a bit of researching, I found a few ways you can actually run Stable Diffusion models on a GPU for free. Here's how. One of the easiest ways to get access to a GPU to run Stable Diffusion models is to ask a friend or relative if you can remotely borrow their computer. Doing this is actually really simple. First, you have them install Automatic 1111's web UI onto the machine along with a few models. As you go to boot it up, add the --share command. As it goes through the boot up process, you'll see a little gradio link appear in the terminal. This special link allows you to have fun generating art on any device for the next few days. Inevitably, there are a couple downsides to this approach that are worth mentioning. This special gradio link will only remain active for 72 hours. So once that link expires, you will no longer be able to access web UI. This means you'll have to ask them to start it back up again and then reshare the new link. Additionally, the gradio link doesn't provide system level access. This means you won't be able to install new models, textual inversions, custom scripts, or export all your images, which can be a bit of a bummer. Of course, to work around this, you could consider arranging a remote desktop or VNC connection to the computer, but obviously this might be a big ask. Another workaround is to use a cloud-based drive like Dropbox or Google Drive to share files between the two computers. Now, if someone on your same network has a GPU, you can use a similar approach, but instead of using the --share command, you can actually boot up web UI with the --listen command. This listen command actually limits access to devices only on the same local network. So what you would do is you'd simply put in the IP address of their computer into your browser, which will look something like 192.168.1.50 with a port of 7860 to then access web UI. And unlike that gradio link, it won't expire after 72 hours. But you will still have the same issue with file access. You either have to share that folder on the local network or again, use a cloud-based solution. Tip number two is to join AI Horde. This crowdsourced distributed cluster is a community that, as stated in their GitHub repository, allows people without a powerful GPU to use Stable Diffusion models. Basically, this virtual community works on a give and take basis where each member contributes something, such as their lower power GPU if they have one, or their time in exchange for a more powerful GPU. As you earn kudos, you can move up the queue and gain priority access to a GPU to begin generating images with Stable Diffusion models. You can learn more about the whole kudos currency system directly on their FAQ page, which we link to in the description below. The system itself is unique, open source, and fairly easy to use. They also have a Discord community where you can ask questions and get help if you need it. It is also one of the most stable ways to make use of diffusion models on our list. Both Amazon SageMaker Studio and Kaggle are some places where you can gain access to a GPU for a limited amount of time, though within limits of either a day or monthly basis. However, we wanted to share a warning here. Similar services like Saturn Cloud and Google Colab have already started to crack down on users leveraging free plans like this. So while SageMaker Studio and Kaggle may currently work, I would not be surprised if this changes in the near future. Anyhow, if you want to try it out, you will need to be fairly comfortable with command line and installing dependencies as there's no one-click beginner-friendly script to get everything started. Additionally, SageMaker Studio is an invite-only basis, so you'll have to request access and then wait for approval, which we found takes about 24 hours before you'll get in. But once you do get everything set up, you can start generating art on their GPUs for free. If you're currently in college or associated with the university, check with the computer science and engineering departments to see if they have any computers for students to use for machine learning purposes. If so, they should have some pretty good GPUs available. Of course, given the academic nature, you may be restricted to using these resources strictly for educational purposes only, which may or may not work depending on your specific use case. Outside of universities, some local tech companies may have outreach initiatives going on to try to recruit highly sought after AI talent within the local community, and as such, may offer access to their computational resources for learning and experimenting. So check locally for events like hackathons and meetups to see if there are any opportunities like this available. So there you have it, a few but limited ideas to run Stable Diffusion models for free. While the list is admittedly short, if you have any other creative ways to run Stable Diffusion models on a GPU without incurring any additional costs, we would love to hear them. Just drop a line so everyone can learn in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.